Okay, oh, I think we got it. Okay, so today we have two, we're going to have two presentations from our own faculty, our outstanding faculty, Dr. Pei Wang from Cellular Structure Biology and Dr. Fisher from Geriatric Center for Healthy Aging, Greg and the Bar Shop. And they're going to tell us about their ongoing research that has been supported to some degree by the Shock Center pilot program. But before that, we just wanted to give you an update and a reminder of our enhanced and improved NIA centers, the Shock Center and the Claude Pepper Center. And as some of you know, these centers are centers of excellence funded by the National Institute on Aging. The Shock Center is funded by the Biology of Aging Division of the Institute. The Claude Pepper Center is a flagship program for funding research from the Geriatrics and Gerontology branch of the National Institute on Aging. So the NIA has four branches. The other is neurobiology, neurosciences, and the fourth one is social-related issues in the elderly. So we have funding centers from two of the branches, and hopefully in the future we'll have more and more. We've been working very hard to bridge our centers, the Claude Pepper Center, which is more focused on translational issues and clinical research, to bridge it with the Shock Center. And our goal is that by bridging these programs, now we have a more comprehensive support system or support mechanism for research. So if you're a basic scientist and you have a great idea, you want to test it in humans, well, you know, now you have the opportunity to work with clinicians, clinical researchers from the Pepper Center and our GREC, our Geriatric Research Center, and we'll help you with the design of the study. Moreover, we'll help you conduct the study. And as you do that, you'll learn more about human research and vice versa. If you're a clinician who's never done basic research, but you're interested in a particular area, we'll pair you through the Shock Center and the Barshop Institute and other resources with a basic scientist. And in that way, yeah, you can also conduct research in areas that you may not have the expertise, but that way you can conduct the research. Moreover, you'll learn more. So that is what I was referring to with these programs that are based on various centers in the university. Now we have the capacity to do research from powerful models such as worm and the fly, and we have various scientists that have expertise in this area. Of course, rodent models, that has been the traditional area of strength of the Barshop Institute. We are getting more and more active in research in non-human primates, particularly using the marmoset model that now is part of both the Shock Center and the Pepper Centers. And we had probably more and more success in getting extramural funding to support our research using marmosets. And that's illustrated by the recent R01 to Dr. Salmon that is studying the effect of rapamycin in the marmoset. And clearly, ultimate goal is to move this science into human subjects. And we're actively doing that as well. This is to illustrate the different funding mechanisms, Shock Center, Pepper Center. Both programs have pilot studies, and some of you might have applied for those. If you haven't, just be in the lookout for those RFAs. We're always looking for exciting research to support. Moreover, our scientists are available and welcoming to help you during the grant writing process. And as many of you know, there's also the Aging Interventions Testing Center for the Intervention Testing Program run by Drs. Strong and Nelson that is to test the effect of pharmacologic and nutraceuticals on aging in rodents. And that is available too through RFAs that are that come directly from the NIA, and Dr. Strong has more details about how to apply for that. He can be contacted for that purpose. So the Shock Center, what is the Shock Center? The name comes from Dr. Nathan Shock and his memory, who's one of the leaders in aging research. And there are six centers in the country, and it's a network, and there's more and more emphasis on networking between centers. Our Shock Center, it's been evolving, and right now we're branding our center as a one-stop shop to do aging biology research. So you have this particular model that even if you're not an aging researcher, but you have a model or an interesting question you want to address, and you need expertise and resources to conduct, to study your model, the Shock Center can help you in a comprehensive manner, help age your mice, help with the with specific interventions such as nutritional interventions, even exercise interventions. That was something we brought in this new renewal. Certainly pharmacologic interventions to look at effects on lifespan. But moreover, because it's a comprehensive center, as we're doing that, we can also look at what we call health span or functional parameters. And our health span core has the capacity really to do very wide array of functional assays, including muscle function, cardiovascular function, immune function, brain function, and the facilities and the equipment to do that are really state of the art. Another key issue in terms of aging studies is learning about the pathology, and I think it's fair to say that we have top pathologist in aging research and at the university. So Dr. Ikeno and his laboratory are available, and he is sought out from all over the world to do pathological analyses of animal models of aging. The other element is also the availability of biostatistical support through Dr. Gelfond and his team. He is probably one of the best also in the world of assessing aging phenotypes from a statistical standpoint. He's also an expert on bioinformatics analysis related to aging research and all the omics methodologies. Another novelty of the renewal of the Shock Center is a pharmacology core, which has two branches. One is a C. elegans branch. This is run by Dr. Fisher, in which we're bringing the capability of doing early stage pharmacologic studies in the worm, and also be able to do some probing of the specific pathways that may be that this pharmacologic agents may be working to potentially affect aging in the worm as an early step, for example, to larger studies using this powerful model. And the other key branch of the pharmacological core, pharmacology core, is the capacity to do pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics of agents that are being used to probe the aging process, such as rapamycin, metformin, and a number of other agents that are becoming more and more available to study aging and aging-related diseases. And what do I mean about pharmacology? Well, if you want to give a drug to your model, you will go to literature typically and find a paper and then just give it to the animal and hope that it's going to reach the concentrations required, that is reaching the tissues required, that is getting absorbed. And I'd say 98% of the papers, there is no really validation of all these parameters. And with the help and the support of Dr. Javers and the core, no, that is feasible. The intervention testing program, as I mentioned, this is funded by NIA. And San Antonio is one of three sites, along with Jackson Laboratory and the University of Michigan. And the mission is to evaluate the potential effects on aging and aging-related parameters of all these different compounds. And the way it works, and Dr. Strong can provide more details or correct me if I'm wrong, but once a year there's an RFA out, and you're interested in evaluating a compound, so you write an application, which is not very large, I think it's a couple of pages, and that gets evaluated by a steering committee, including NIH, the ITT investigators, and other scientists, based on that decisions of that committee, certain compounds are selected each year, and you remain when you don't. While you don't get money to conduct the research here, your study is conducted through the consortium, and you're part of the science. You're part of the publications. You get access to data, depending on different arrangements, you've got tissues and things of that nature, The RFA comes once a year. Is that right, Randy? And I'm going to finish with the Pepper Center. The goal here is to conduct translational research related to aging in humans and also in marmosets as a model of, as a non-human primate model. The focus has been, is primarily on evaluating interventions, pharmacological interventions, but also we're accept applications from other types of interventions that you may want to test, including nutritional or exercise or other type of interventions. There are several cores. One is the biostatistical core that is essentially somewhat similar to the one for the shock center is Dr. Galfon and his group, but here the focus is more on geriatrics and gerontology. There's a clinical research core, so we provide guidance and support for conducting the research in the patients. So we help with preparing the protocol, preparing the regulatory documentation. We help with pairing you with a study coordinator, a physician or nurses, so you can carry out your project. There is a preclinical core, which is essentially the marmoset core. So we provide support for people that want to do studies using the marmoset. The Other core is the other two key cores. One is a pilot studies and exploratory studies core. That's also the Shock Center, both the Shock Center and the Pepper Center fund pilot projects. Projects that are purely on rodents or cells that are not human cells likely will be better matched for the Shock Center. Applications that are geared towards humans, they could be very basic oriented questions, basic biology, but if it's in humans, it will be probably a better match for the Pepper Center. And if you're going to propose to use marmosets, it could, or other non-human primate models, it could be a match for both. And the other core that that Pepper Center funds, that's a very important one, is that it has a career development core. So it protects it pays the salaries of three people per year, 75% of their salary to protect their research, protected time for research. So that's also a very good opportunity. So just be out in the lookout for these RFAs and encourage you to come talk to us anytime if you want to know if you're interested in doing aging research and if that's something that you've never done but you want to get involved in it. We have a number of people that are available to help you design your study and also to help you to as you carry out your research. And I'm going to stop here.